Hi students, this is Alex here. In this video, we are going to find the eigenvalues and eigenvectors for the given matrix of order 3. As a first part, we have to write the characteristic equation, which is A minus lambda I determinant equal to 0. When we subtract lambda I, all the leading diagonal elements will get minus lambda. So here 1 minus lambda, this is 0 minus lambda, and the rest of the elements will be as it is. So this gives A minus lambda I, and this determinant we have to equate to 0. Now let's go for expansion. So first element minus 2 minus lambda, then we have to take these 4 elements and multiply, which is 1 minus lambda into minus lambda, then minus 6 into minus 2 is 12, and we have to subtract. Then second element minus 2, then we have to take these 4 elements. So if I multiply these 2, I will get minus 2 lambda. Then when I multiply these 2, I will get 6, but I have to subtract, so minus 6. In the last element minus 3, then we have to take these 4 elements, we have to multiply this, which is minus 4. And we have to multiply this, so it will become plus 1 into 1 minus lambda, which is equal to 0. Now further, the first term let's write as it is. Then here we have to multiply minus lambda inside, so minus lambda plus lambda square minus 12, and here we will multiply minus 2 inside, so plus 4 lambda plus 12. And here it is minus 3, and inside the bracket we have minus 4 plus 1, which is minus 3, then minus lambda equal to 0. Now we have to multiply this minus 2 inside, so it will become 2 lambda minus 2 lambda square plus 24. Now we have to multiply minus lambda inside, so plus lambda square minus lambda cube plus 12 lambda. Then here we have 4 lambda plus 12, and this minus 3 I have to multiply inside, which we get plus 9 and plus 3 lambda equal to 0. Now we have to rearrange. The first term we have to write minus lambda cube. Then apart from that, all the lambda square terms we have to group together. We have two terms which is having lambda square. So by adding this, we get minus lambda square. After this, all the lambda terms we have to group together. This is 2 lambda, 12 lambda, 4 lambda and 3 lambda. So everything is positive. So 2, and this is 14, then 18, then 21. Totally, we get 21 lambda. So plus 21 lambda. Then all the numbers. So here it is 24. And this is 12 and 9. So by adding all the three numbers, we get plus 45, which is equal to 0. Now, throughout we have to change the sign. So lambda cube plus lambda square minus 21 lambda minus 45 equal to 0. On solving this, we get three values for lambda. So first let's use the factor theorem. When we substitute a particular value for lambda, say lambda equal to 1, we have to check whether it gives 0. If it gives 0, then lambda minus 1 will be a factor. So this will give first term 1 cube is 1, then lambda square is 1, minus 21, minus 45. This is definitely not equal to 0. Now let's take another value, minus 1. Then this is minus 1 plus 1. Plus 21 minus 45. Definitely, this is also not equal to 0. Now let's try with number 2. So first term is 8, second term is 4, then minus 42, then minus 45. Definitely, this is also not equal to 0. So we have to try with minus 2. So this will give minus 8, then plus 4, then plus 42, then minus 45, and this gives minus 4, first two term, and the last two term gives minus 3 and this is not equal to 0. Then I have to try with the next number 3. 3 cube 27, then plus 9 minus 63 minus 45. Again, this is a big negative number, so not equal to 0. Now let's try with lambda equal to minus 3. So minus 27, then plus 9, then plus 63 and minus 45. Let's simplify this. First two terms gives minus 18. Then these two terms, 63 minus 45 gives plus 18. So that gives 0. So this particular value of lambda satisfies the equation. So from this we come to know minus 3 is one of the factor. And if I know one factor using synthetic division, I can get the another two factors. So let's write all the coefficients 1, 1, minus 21 and 45. So here 1, 1, minus 21 and minus 45. So all the coefficients of lambda cube, lambda square and lambda, then constant term we have written. 1, 1, minus 21, minus 45. And since we know one factor minus 3, let's use this directly. So here always we have to put 0. We have to add this and write it here. We have to multiply these two numbers, minus 3 and 1, and write it here. Then add this, we get minus 2. Then multiply these two, we get 6. Then this gives minus 15. Then by multiplying, we get 45. And by adding this, we get 0. Now, the remaining part of the numbers, we have to write it as a quadratic equation. Lambda square minus 2 lambda minus 15 equal to 0. The product is minus 15, sum is minus 2. So which is lambda minus 5 into lambda plus 3 equal to 0. From this we get two values, one is 5, another is minus 3, and in the starting already we got one value minus 3. So using that only we calculated by synthetic division. So one value is minus 3 and another two values we got. Therefore finally lambda values are minus 3, minus 3 and 5. Here two values are repeated value. So these three values are the eigen values. Now let's find the eigenvector for each eigen values. Let x1 be eigenvector for lambda equal to minus 3. Let's take a matrix from the characteristic equation. So this is the equation we had, A minus lambda I. So we have taken that matrix, and x1 is another matrix which is having three elements, x1, x2 and x3, and this value equal to 0. Now we have to substitute lambda as minus 3 in this equation. So the first element will be minus 2 minus 3, then 2 minus 3, then 2. When I put minus 3 here, we get 1 plus 3, then minus 6, then minus 1, minus 2, and this will become plus 3. Then into, as usual, x1, x2, x3 equal to 0. Now, let's simplify these numbers. The first number is minus 5, then 2 and minus 3, then 2, 4, minus 6, then minus 1, minus 2, and 3. Now we are going to expand this by multiplying the first row with first column corresponding elements in the same way all the other rows also. So now the first equation will be minus 5x1 plus 2x2 minus 3x3 equal to 0. Then second row multiplying in the same way, we get 2x1 plus 4x2 minus 6x3 equal to 0. Then minus x1 minus 2x2 plus 3x3 equal to 0. We got three equations, and we notice that the last two equations are proportional. If I divide the first equation by minus 2, I will get the second equation. So these two are proportional. But anyway, the other equation is different. So we are going to consider the first two equations and we are going to use the cross multiplication method. So we will write x1 by, leave the x1, write the coefficient of x2, that is 2, 4, then coefficient of x3, minus 3, minus 6. So we will take it as a determinant. Then we have to write x2, then we have to write the coefficient of x3, minus 3, minus 6, then coefficient of x1, which is minus 5 and 2, then equal to x3. Again, after writing this x3, we have to write the coefficient of x1, which is minus 5 and plus 2, then coefficient of x2, which is 2 and 4. Now we are going to evaluate this 2 by 2 determinant, that is x1 by, when we multiply this, we get minus 12 and this is plus 12. So that gives us 0. Now x2 by minus 6, then minus 6 by are 30. It is 30 plus 30, but we have to subtract. Then x3 divided by minus 20 minus 4. So finally we get x1 by 0, then x2 by minus 36 and x3 by minus 24. Now we will take it as a simplest ratio by dividing by minus 12. So if I divide all the denominator by minus 12, this is anyway 0 and this will give 3 and next number will give 2 by dividing by minus 12, the denominator part. So from this we got the one eigenvector, which is 0, 3, 2. After that we have to calculate the eigenvector for the another eigenvalue, but we see there is a repeated value. Already minus 3 we completed, but next value is also minus 3. So if I work out in the same way, we get the same matrix product and same equation and we get the same answer. But here we already discussed that the two equations are proportional. So among this two equation, let's take the simplest one and we'll copy that separately. Now already in the first eigenvector x1, we have the first element as 0. So because of this, I'm going to substitute here, let x2 equal to 0, second element as 0. So minus x1 and this will become 0 plus 3x3 equal to 0. Now let's take this to the other side. So minus x1 equal to minus 3x3 and we can cancel the minus, and x1 by this 3 I can bring it to the denominator equal to x3 by, there is nothing in the denominator, so it is 1. So we can take the proportional values of x1, x2 and x3. That is the simplest ratio as our eigen vector. So x1 is 3, x2 we took it as 0 and x3 is 1. So in the same way we can take any value as 0, either x2 or x3. I can also take, let x3 equal to 0. If that is the case, we get minus x1 minus 2x2 equal to 0. Then minus x1 equal to 2x2. Now this is minus x1 by 2 equal to x2 by 1. So this minus I can bring it here. If I take the ratio minus 2, 1 and x3 is 0. So we got the another eigenvector. So when we get linearly dependent equation like this, we can get more than one value for eigenvector, but we can take any one case. So here we are going to take the first case. Now there is another value of lambda phi which we have to work out and get the eigenvector x3. Let's write x3 be the eigenvector for the lambda phi, and we have written the characteristic equation matrix, and from this we multiplied the eigenvector and equated to 0. we are going to substitute the value of lambda here. So the first value will become minus 2 minus 5, which is minus 7, then 2 minus 3, then this is 2 and minus 4 and minus 6, then minus 1, minus 2 and minus 5. And we multiplied with x1, x2, x3. Now we are going to multiply this in the same way. The first row multiplied with the first column of the corresponding elements. In the same way, other rows also. So the first equation will be minus 7x1 plus 2x2 minus 3x3 equal to 0. Then 2x1 minus 4x2 minus 6x3 equal to 0. And third equation is minus x1 minus 2x2 minus 5x3 equal to 0. Now let's take any two equation. So we'll take the first and second equation. We are going to use the cross multiplication method, that is x1 by, we have to write the coefficient of x2, then coefficient of x3, and this is a 2 by 2 determinant. In the same way, we have to write x2 and we have to write the coefficient of x3, then coefficient of x1, then we have to write x3 and we have to write the coefficient of x1, then coefficient of x2. Now we are going to evaluate all the 2 by 2 determinant. So this is x1 by minus 12, then minus 12, then x2 by minus 6, then minus 42, then x3 by 28 minus 4. Now simplifying this, we get x1 by minus 24, x2 by minus 48, x3 by 24. By taking the simplest ratio, we can divide by minus 12 all the denominators, so we get 2. Then if I divide by minus 12, this will become 4. Actually, we can divide by 24 itself. So when I divide by minus 24, this will become 1, and this will become 2, and this will become minus 1. So from this we get the eigenvector, which is 1, 2, minus 1. So for this given matrix, we got the eigenvalues minus 3, minus 3 and 5. Then 3 eigenvector, x1 what we got is here 0, 3, 2. Let's write it here 0, 3, 2. Then x2 what we got is, that we worked out here, 301 or minus 210. We'll take 301. So here it is 301. Then x3 is 1, 2, minus 1. Suppose if I take the another part, that is minus 210, then our answer will be, or we have written all the lambda values and x1, x3, and x2 we have to write minus 2, 1, 0. So here it is going to be minus 2, 1, 0. So the answer can be either this or this.